Do you ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head? Hi, Yale. My name is Autumn. Allow me to explain. December 16th, 2020 was a day I'd been both longing for and dreading. I panicked until 4 o'clock, the fateful hour. Upon receiving the fateful notification, I opened my fateful email and... yeah. Within a few minutes, I had reconciled. Hope was far from lost, so I considered my options. Whatever was on my application already was unchangeable, so my options were to wait or to add. To add something that would catch Yale's eye, to make them see the Yale in me. The idea hit me a few days later. As a distance runner, I have a habit of appraising things by how many miles I'd run for them, and I realized I'd run a marathon for Yale. Given the circumstances, I didn't have the luxury of access to an official marathon, so I created my own. The Yale Marathon. Each of the 26 miles would have its own specific dedication, a reason that would answer the question, why Yale? The route, too, was curated, hoping to give Yale a better idea of myself and my community along the way. I knew it was a long shot, but I figured I'd go big or go home. I set the date for January 24th, weather agreeing, and as luck would have it, it did. A playlist was made, a support team hired, and a Gatorade chugged. Once my clothing was layered and my shoes double knotted, I was ready.
You can see it snowed a little bit last night, but it's okay, not too bad. And I'm about to start, here we go!
The first leg of the marathon was defined by its route through my hometown, Wauwatosa. I passed landmarks of my childhood like my elementary school, my middle school, and the parkway which I usually run on. This leg was easy. I was optimistic, energized, and I was wired by adrenaline.
Mile one, my reason is the people. Reason number two is how the intramural sports compete between the residential colleges. That'd be so fun. Mile three, and the reason is the campus. It's so beautiful and gothic, and it looks good in summer and winter. Fourth mile, fourth reason, campus theater scene.
I was going to explain why I'm drawn to Yale Theater, but I think it kind of speaks for itself.
5 miles in, my reason is the alumni network. Clearly their dedication is a huge green flag, and it's something that I would be involved in after graduation. Mile six, New Haven. 7 is for ensembles like the Yale Symphony Orchestra. Mile 8 is for my little sister Fallon. I think she looks up to me and I want to set a good example for her.
Mile 9, gonna pull out a classic, the residential college system.
The second leg of the run began on the Hank Aaron State Trail, which was purposeful. This trail is special to me, reminding me of summer spent biking to the Art Museum, Miller Park, and Lake Michigan. At this point, I'd really settled into a steady groove, and I was feeling pretty good physically.
10, an absolutely unbeatable international relations program. Mile 11, my reason is the beautiful running trails around New Haven. Just like we have the Hank Aaron State Trail here. Mile 12 is for the sweet system. Reason 13, halfway by the way, is the tradition of Yale. Yale is older than the US, and that's amazing. 13, the Yale Running Club.
Despite the fact that I do most of my running alone nowadays, I love running with people and I can't wait to be on a real team again.
Mile 15, the batteries. For mile 16, my reason is to make my family proud.
And just like that, I'd reached the third leg, defined by its route through the streets of downtown Milwaukee. I was, at this point, starting to feel a little tired, but mentally I wasn't having too much difficulty. Yet. Plus, my dad and sister surprised me by coming to cheer me on.
Mile 17, it's campus resources like the U-Blend app. Mile 18, the East Coast pace of life. I seek a campus where there's something to go to every hour, every minute. I want to be busy, and that's what Yale can give me. Mile 19, study abroad options like the Yale summer session. Mile 20, the Atlantic Ocean. Although I love Lake Michigan, it is really no match.
At this point, I was in the home stretch, the final leg, when I ran along Lake Michigan on Lakeshore Drive. I'm not gonna lie, the last 5 miles were painful. You might see some tears. But the end was almost literally in sight, so I just focused on putting one foot in front of the other.
Mile 21, the libraries. Number 22, well, don't tell Harvard I said this, but Yale is better. 23.
Yale's chapter of Camp Kasem.
Mile 24, amazing professors at Yale. 25, the residential college dances and events. My last reason, it's not Hogwarts, but it's the next best thing.
And there you have it. After 26.2 miles, after more than 4 hours, after running a course that circled the only home I'd ever known.
I did it!
So that brings us to now, more than a month later. Looking back on the whole process, I can say that a month or 2 months ago, I had no idea what a huge project this would become. Running the marathon was the easy part. But no matter what the outcome turns out to be, I have absolutely no regrets about starting it. I've learned so much about animation, videography, iMovie, and honestly about myself as well. Before I end this video, I have a very important point that I'd like to make. I don't think that being able to run a marathon inherently qualifies me as a good candidate for Yale. I don't think it qualifies anyone, but I see the marathon that I ran more as a medium that I use to express the qualities that do. Things like perseverance and being able to think creatively. And finally, I'd like to say thanks to you, Yale. Of course, thanks for taking the time to watch this video, but also thank you for inspiring me. It's because of you that I went the extra mile, the extra 26 miles. Because of Yale, I was inspired and motivated, and I did achieve something that I would have never tried in the first place. I hope it's not the last time that I get to say that.